stations of the cross ended at the 12th station, that we did not recognize Jesus being taken from the cross and being laid in the tomb. We need not imagine that because we know that through the death of Christ, we live in hope. The hope that sustained the Blessed Mother through the most difficult and painful moment of her life, seeing her son humiliated and nailed to a cross. Yesterday, the church celebrated the feast of the exaltation of the cross, which is linked to today, the celebration of Our Lady of Sorrows. And when I was preaching with the students yesterday, I shared with them that as believers, we know that the cross is not a dead end. For some people, they see Jesus' death as a failure, and they do not know the power of the Spirit that raised Him from the dead that is in all of our lives. As we stay close to Mary, as we stay close to her Son. So Jack read for us a beautiful passage in John's Gospel, where in his pain and anguish, Jesus said, "Mother, behold your son. Son, behold your mother." A truth that continues to go forth to each and every one of us, and of all people of faith. Keeping vigil by one dying, brings up many different emotions. We cannot even imagine the depth of the anguish that Mary suffered. Yesterday morning, the rectory phone rang, and there was a request to join people keeping vigil as a loved one was dying. A friend had reached out with compassion. A daughter was cuddled up next to her mother in her bed, as her husband of decades was standing at her foot, doing all that he could to bring comfort to her. We gathered in faith. The sacrament of anointing was offered, and the dying woman was not able to receive the Eucharist, so her daughter next to her, her husband at her foot, received the Eucharist for her. The richness of our faith touches all moments of our lives. And as I look out at the community gathered and those who are streaming today, I know without doubt that there are a number of people who have made pilgrimages to the Holy Land and have spent time in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. I know that there are people here who have been able to go on pilgrimage to Fatima. Our rich faith allows us to go out to the church to come to us. For decades, this statue has traveled across state lines, around the world, so that the message of the Prince of Peace, the message of the Queen of Peace that was needed to be proclaimed 2,000 years ago, that was needed to be proclaimed in the early 1910s, continues to be known and shared in us so that we will be peacemakers. We will be people who keep vigil with those dying. We will stay close to the Blessed Mother and her Son in whom we have our hope. Mary at the foot of the cross is not the final chapter of our deep faith. Jesus dying on the cross is not the final chapter. For by the gift of God's grace, the resurrection is the hope that sustains and guides each and every one of us in our lived, in our shared faith. So throughout the day today, as we welcome and receive and spend time with the statue of Our Lady of Fatima on this pilgrimage of peace, we don't even need to pack luggage or a passport. We just need to come and open our hearts anew to the devotion that Mary offered to her son through all the moments of joy and pain in his life. As we pray that in those moments of the cross in our lives, in the moments of the cross of others, we may be instruments of hope. A hope that knows that even through death, hope reigns supreme, because God would not allow death and the Spirit be the final chapter of any person, any individual's life. life continues to reign, and peace reigns for all eternity with Mary and our Savior, and the joys and promises of heaven. And so, as a believing people, streaming and gathered in the Church of St. Mary, we bring before the Lord our prayers and our needs.
We pray for our church.
We pray for
Lord. We pray that it may be guided by Our Lady of Fatima, and bring more people to salvation. We pray to the Lord. Pray for our nation, that on this tour of Our Lady, this tour of peace of Our Lady of Fatima, more and more people may come to believe in Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an end to the war in Ukraine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those that are sick, that through the intercession of Mary, they may find comfort, healing,
Our Lady of Sorrows, we turn to you. May her example and witness of